It took a long time, but it's finally here. AMD's first ever hybrid CPU, codenamed Phoenix 2, combines Zen 4 and Zen 4C CPU cores into a single chip. Long after ARM started the hybrid hype with big.LITTLE and Intel introduced its P and E core design with Alder Lake, AMD finally seems to follow suit. Or are they? Let's take a closer look at AMD's new Phoenix 2 APU. And without spoiling anything, once we dive into the silicon level, AMD's very unique take on hybrid CPUs quickly becomes apparent, because calling it big.LITTLE is very true and completely wrong at the same time. It's quite unusual to get such a high quality die shot, especially before the official launch of a product. But this leak by Twitter user HXL gives us the unique opportunity to take an in-depth look at AMD's idea of asymmetrical CPU design. Let's dive right in and see what secrets are hidden inside AMD's Phoenix 2 APU. Very easy to spot is the large outward-facing DDR5 memory interface, which provides the physical connections for the RAM. Right next to it, and also somewhat in between, we can find the integrated memory controller. Controller and interface work together to connect the rest of the chip with the external DDR5 memory. If we stay at the edges of the chip, we can find a bunch of physical USB and display ports to the right and bottom right corner of the chip, marked in blue. At the bottom of the chip, we can also make out a couple of PCI Express physical layers. Basically, everything that is supposed to interface with something outside of the chip is located at the edges of the chip. Continuing, there's a media engine to the right of the memory controller, and below that we have one of the two main actors of the chip, the RDNA 3 iGPU. We can see the large GPU complex and the two individual RDNA 3 workgroups with a total of 4 compute units, much less than the 12 compute units of its bigger brother Phoenix. Something else that has been cut compared to Phoenix is the Ryzen AI engine, which is completely missing from Phoenix 2. The initial codename, Phoenix.LITTLE, might actually be a better fit considering all the downgrades so far, especially since it's a physical smaller chip to begin with. But that's where Phoenix 2 stops being normal, because if we turn our attention to the elephant in the room, the CPU, everything changes. And Phoenix 2 suddenly turns into a very interesting chip. When I'm looking for the CPU complex on a die shot, I usually start by looking for a big block of cache. And while the 60 megabytes of shared L3 cache are easy to spot in this die shot, the attached CPU cores are unlike anything else we have ever seen. If I just highlight the L3 cache and the attached cores, you can clearly see that we are looking at an asymmetrical layout. It almost looks like something went wrong. Gone is the usual symmetry of CPU designs. So what are we actually looking at? The best way to bring some order into this asymmetrical chaos is by identifying the individual CPU cores first. On one side of the L3 cache, we have a row of 3 Zen 4C cores, and on the other side we have the very odd combination of 2 standard Zen 4 cores and a single Zen 4C core. 6 CPU cores in total, though 2 of them are not like the others. AMD has talked a lot about Zen 4C, but I think this die chart right here is the best way to show the very obvious size difference. Compared to Zen 4, a Zen 4C core is a little bit wider, but much shorter. AMD claims that the C core is using about 35% less area, and to be honest, it looks even smaller. But here's the kicker. From a microarchitecture point of view, both core types are exactly the same. Yes, these are the same cores despite the very obvious visible differences. Before a CPU is actually produced in silicon, engineers create a detailed design abstraction. In digital circuit design, this is the so-called register transfer level, or RTL for short. I'm sure you have seen fancy schematics like this one before. It's a technical description of how the CPU functions, and engineers use the RTL as a template to then implement it on a silicon level with transistors. Both Zen 4 and Zen 4C are based on the same RTL. They support the same instruction set architecture, and they even have the same IPC, which means at the same clock speeds, both cores have the same performance. And yes, both variants also have the same 1 megabyte of L2 cache. But how is that possible? There's 2 main reasons that explain the size difference. The first is cell density. In semiconductor engineering, you can place the individual cells closer together or further apart. This slide from an older AMD presentation does a good job at showing the differences in cell density. The advantages of using high density cells are obvious. you save precious silicon area. But there are also disadvantages, mainly in the area of clock speeds and thermals. Denser cells might not support high clock speeds because of crosstalk and signal integrity. And if you pack more transistors into the same area, you also create more heat. Zen4C in general uses more high density cells than Zen4, reducing its size, but at the same time negatively impacting the clock speed potential. But high density cells alone don't explain the entire size difference. Another important aspect is how AMD actually implemented the layout. Modern CPU cores are very complex and require multiple teams to work on different parts of the core. Basically, the work is split up, not only into main parts like one team for the L2 cache, one team for the integer unit and another team for the floating point unit, but it's even more fine-grained. In this slide from AMD, we can see a detailed comparison of Zen 4 and Zen 4C. The layout, especially of the integer and FP units, look completely different. The standard Zen 4 core is broken up into a lot of smaller areas, divided by small but visible lines, while Zen 4C looks much more random. The guys over at SemiAnalysis did an amazing job, labeling all the individual clusters. All these tiny areas of Zen 4 are designed individually and then combined to create the CPU core itself. A Zen 4 core is basically a lot of individual puzzle pieces put together. That way, if you have to fix and redesign parts of the core during the implementation process, you only have to redesign the affected sub-area and not the entire core itself. A huge advantage and basically the only way to bring a modern design to market in a reasonable timeframe and within budget. But it also has a major drawback. It's hard to optimize for area efficiency because each team is limited to their own sub-area and, for example, can bring another part onto their puzzle piece even if it would save space. Zen4C, on the other hand, had a completely different design process. Instead of designing multiple smaller sub-areas individually, those areas are already merged during the design process, which means they can be packed much closer together as you don't have to stay inside of your small sub-area when creating the layout. That's why even when using the same architectural design abstraction, Zen 4 and Zen 4C look so much different. Zen 4C was uncompromisingly designed with the goal of area efficiency, even at the cost of clock speed. The result is two very different layouts of the same CPU core architecture. It's here where AMD's unique approach to hybrid CPUs becomes apparent, because AMD is doing something radically different compared to ARM's big.LITTLE and Intel's P and E cores. At first glance, big.LITTLE seems like the perfect description of Zen 4 and Zen 4C, since there is a very obvious size difference. Zen 4 is big and Zen 4C is little. But that's where the similarities stop, because big.LITTLE not only refers to the physical size, but also to the architecture. Apple's M2 is a great example of ARM's big.LITTLE. Not only are the little cores a lot smaller than the big cores, a difference much greater than 35%, these two core types also use different architectures. Apple calling them high performance and high efficiency cores is much more fitting description. A M2 Max with only little cores would lose the majority of its performance, while Phoenix 2 would still perform very well even with only Zen 4C cores. We can see the same when we look at Intel's P and E cores. First, the area difference again is much greater than 35%. A single P core is larger than two E cores. And secondly, the E cores use a different architecture. The larger Golden and Raptor Cove cores are a much wider design with bigger caches, AVX512 support and hyperthreading. The small Gracemont cores have much less IPC and don't support either AVX512 or hyperthreading. The result is a huge IPC difference, especially in multi-threaded applications. So what does Phoenix 2 tell us about AMD's hybrid CPU strategy? Well, to be honest, it tells us that, at least at this point, AMD doesn't think that a true hybrid design, combining two different CPU architectures into one chip, is the way to go. AMD just isn't under any pressure when it comes to the size of its CPU cores. A simple area-optimized version of their high IPC Zen 4 core is all that is needed to compete on performance per square millimeter, without the need to implement a different underlying architecture. Zen 4C might not play a huge role for your standard desktop CPU, but it rules high core count server chips and allows small APUs, like Phoenix 2, to scale up to 6 high IPC cores with minimal impact on die size. And if we use our imagination, something like Zen 5C might be the perfect fit for a next-gen Steam Deck. Small cores with a lot of punch in a small form factor that wouldn't even allow for high clock speeds anyways. Now I want to know your thoughts about Zen 4C and the upcoming Zen 5C from AMD. Would you consider going for more cores with lower clock speeds? And do you think that at some point AMD might actually start designing a different architecture for the area optimized cores like ARM and Intel? Leave a comment down below. I hope you found this video interesting and see you in the next one.